So everyone's talking about humanoid robots replacing humans, robots like Tesla Optimus, Neo, and Figure. But what you may not know is that there are already millions and millions of robots replacing jobs and replacing human roles. And today we're gonna cover the top 7 industrial robots that are replacing people just like you and me and what you need to know to stay relevant. Make sure you like and subscribe to the channel because 6 days a week, I'm bringing you a fresh video on how AI and robotics are impacting you in your world. We gotta remain relevant, respected, and financially free, guys. And this is the channel where we cover that. So firstly, let's just state that robots are really gonna replace work that's dangerous, repetitive, predictable. There's not a lot of human to human connection. It's kind of these mundane tasks that, quite frankly, you might not want to do, but you might have to do to feed your family. Regardless, robots are making a huge wave. The first robot that we're going to cover here are autonomous mining trucks. These are huge, large industrial size trucks from places like Caterpillar. They're safer, they work 24/7, 365, and early reports show that they improve productivity by up to 30%. Now, there are already 690 of these large industrial mining trucks in use, and there is an expectation there's gonna be over 2,000 in place by 2030. These replace truck drivers, on-site logistical staff, and supervisors. And again, there are estimated to be huge amount of these trucks in the near future and an estimate of up to 30% of all mining tasks replaced by 2030. So by the way, if you're a dwarf who digs under the world and under the earth, you know, it might be time to start thinking about different ways to mine because autonomous trucks are huge. Now, I'm not gonna get into it in this video, but when you start to see these types of technologies run out in mining and construction sites, you could start to see, well, what about semi-trucks and stuff? You know, we're not seeing autonomous semi-trucks, autonomous vehicles just take off just yet, but I'm sure we'll be covering that in the very near future. Okay, let's cover our next robot here, which is the Da Vinci surgical system. These are precision operation assistance, robots that help surgeons perform minimally invasive surgery. And I know what you're thinking, Mark, I don't necessarily know that I would want a robot poking around inside of me to perform surgery, but guys, there are already 7,500 active robotic surgeons. They've already performed over 14 million procedures globally. So these robots are here and they're replacing surgical assistants and technicians in the operating room. Isn't that kind of weird that you could be, this kind of reminds me of Alien where the girl gets into this machine and it like extracts the tumor or the alien out of her stomach. We are not that far off. And you can also see how revolutions like this, well, they may displace some of the workers, could also bring down healthcare costs tremendously. Man, that whole idea of I want to become a doctor, my parents want me to become a doctor or a surgeon, might not be as enticing in the near future as these Da Vinci robots. I was shocked, 14 million procedures already performed. How many do you think are going to be performed next year in 2026? Probably a lot. The next robots that we're gonna talk about here today are the Kiva systems, which are Amazon robotics, and these are used for warehousing and fulfillment, picking, sorting, transporting inventory. Guys, there are already 1 million of these robots. There's already 1 million of these logistical warehouse robots in Amazon warehouses. And we covered this in length in another video. I encourage you to check that if you're interested. I'll put a link to it here. There's over 1 million of these robots. There's almost more robots in Amazon warehouses than humans. And to me, this is fascinating because just a year ago, I posted a video about these robots in Amazon warehouses and someone said, well, I couldn't believe this. This is so crazy. People were flaming me saying, well, robots can't take my job because I work in a warehouse and I'm doing stuff that robots can't do. Well, it turns out that you better keep your head on a swivel because they are here and there's over 1 million of them. They're replacing warehouse pickers, inventory runners, forklift operators. You're gonna need less supervisors on staff. And Amazon says that they're seeing productivity gains of up to 40% per warehouse. In fact, an internal leaked memo from Amazon showed that they plan to displace 600,000 jobs by 2033 by implementing more and more robotics, more and more efficiency in the logistics chain. And that's just a prediction for the future that was in that internal leak memo. I have an entire video on that here too. Amazon, very fascinating what they're doing with AI and robotics, so you can check that out here. But an MIT study suggests that all these robots have already replaced 400,000 jobs in Amazon warehouses. I'll tell you what, if those numbers don't shock you, I don't know what will. Well, maybe it'll be the next robot on our list, which is a lawn cutting robot from Husqvarna. It's a professional robotic mower. And you know, these are gonna be used on places like golf courses or large municipal parks, large fields. All you Forrest Gumps out there who are just really just wanting to mow the lawn, you might not have that job for much longer. There's approximately over 2 million of these lawn mowing robots already out in the field. 2 million, holy cow, I can't believe how many robots there already are out there. Can you believe it? Shocking. In fact, I've actually seen these in the wild. I was visiting Poland with my wife and kids last year, and we were visiting Warsaw, the capital, and they had several of these robots cutting the lawn outside of the Capitol building. And that was the first time I saw them. I said, wow. The robots are here, boys. The robots are here. Okay, next on here, we have the John Deere autonomous tractors, which are autonomous robotic vehicles used in farming. And this to me is pretty interesting as they can scale up, insane amounts. They're used for plowing, seeding, spraying, and even harvesting crops. Guys, they're gonna cut down the field work, they reduce the labor costs, and they reduce the amount of chemical waste. And it's, you know, listen, these are in the early stages. I saw a lot of conflicting reports, so it's hard to say exactly how many or what the impact is of these agricultural robots, but please believe they are here and there are going to be more. That is happening. Okay, the next robot on our list are the Softbank Robotics Whiz. And these are used for hotel cleaning. And these essentially are giant Roombas. And they are used to vacuum large lobbies, hallways, carpeted areas. I've actually seen these in the wild in a few different places. You may have too. If you've seen these in the wild, type in a comment below. I was in DC for a conference for Meta about 2 years ago, and they had this giant industrial robot cleaning. I was speaking at an event at Entrepreneur Organization 3 years ago, and I talked to a guy who was selling these robots to hotels. So I know a guy who's selling them. I've seen them in the wild, and they are already out there, guys. And you know, they're not gonna be able to do all of the cleaning, but if you think in the past you had to have a housekeeper kind of going in and vacuuming all these large spaces, that would be very time consuming. Now a robot can do all of it, and then the human can just kind of come in and clean up some of the tight areas. At least for now. In fact, I've even seen these at 7-Eleven. There's a 7-Eleven near where I live that has a robot that goes around and mops the floor. So, wow. Everyone is worried about these humanoids, and they are cool, but holy cow, the robots are here. The next one on our list is the ABB industrial manufacturing robots. And these are used for welding, painting, assembly line, putting materials together. These are performing high precision, repetitive, and sometimes dangerous work. And they replace welders, assembly line workers, and machine operators. And you're probably already aware that there's a lot of robots and machines inside manufacturing warehouses. But what you might not know is that while there are 400,000 of these manufacturing robots here in the US, there are over 2 million in China. And China is eating America's lunch when it comes to these manufacturing robots. I'm recording an entire video on this here, and you can post that. You can check out that video here. Guys, regardless of what you want to say about robots and AI, it's very, very clear that they are transforming the world that we live, and we need to absolutely adapt. You got to be looking at your exact field and how robots are playing a part. You know, this isn't, we're not even getting into autonomous vehicles. We're not even getting into Tesla robo-taxis, or even drones, or autonomous planes, but all these things are starting to play out and replace human jobs. Now, does that mean that you're not gonna have a job? No, but it does mean that you're gonna need to adapt the way that you operate. And my recommendation is really focusing on human-to-human relationships, emotional connection. These are jobs that are not ready or able to be replaced by robots, at least just yet. Guys, if you liked today's video, thanks for liking and subscribing. Make sure you subscribe to my newsletter. It is completely free, AIupdate.ai. It's completely free. I cover all the news there that I can't cover in the videos. And if you liked today's video, check out yesterday's video. I think it's really interesting. It's what's happening in consulting and how AI is replacing consulting jobs at an unprecedented place. McKinsey, one of the biggest consultancies in the world, is laying off thousands and thousands of employees. Is it all AI? Is their company doing bad? You gotta watch yesterday's video in order to find out. All right, boys, make it great. I'll see you next video. Peace.